Sir, I believe that joining civil services at such a young age will give me such a huge responsibility, and it will give me a platform to bridge the gap between the haves and have-nots, and it will give me immense satisfaction to work for millions of people, sir.
What are the qualities which you will bring to this job?
Sir, I am from a computer science background, so whatever I have learned in my college, that skills I will try to use.
Wasn't the skills, I'm talking about the qualities, character, quality, personality traits.
Okay, sir. Sir, while I was in my college, I was a member of Kashyukas, where I used to lead a team of 12 men. So I have that leadership
just
skills.
Enumerate the quality, instead of saying when I was there, you can say you were able to lead, which means you have leadership quality. That is one quality. So we believe leadership qualities you have, what else?
Empathy. Especially for the underprivileged and women community. Then compassion for the underprivileged.
Okay. Now, when you talk of leadership quality, what do you understand by that?
It means to lead a team of, let's say, whatever number of people. And in order to lead them, you have to motivate.
Leader must have some solid quality.
Yes,
sir. What kind of this quality, which you are not identified?
The first is good communication skills. Then the ability to take others on board while they are reluctant. And ability to give the credit of success to others and to own the failures.
Okay.
So these are.
Honesty, you don't consider integrity a quality. Otherwise, how will they respect the leader?
Yes, sir. These are all.
No?
Yes, sir.
Professional competence, moral courage, you don't think, is it?
So these are all the traits,
yeah?
You're right.
So you're talking of everything, but you're not talking of the basic. You believe in rule of law or not?
Yes, sir.
Is that not a quality?
Yes, sir, it is also.
I find that you have played cricket for your college. Can you tell me why India has been in the news recently? Indian cricket team in particular.
India has won the series against South Africa.
Yeah.
And it was the first win in South Africa against the team. Apart from this, Indian women team has also been in use with similar opposition and the same place.
Thank you. Okay. You are a technocrat, so how do you view the current job situation in the country, particularly for technical people?
Sir, service sector don't provide that much job as manufacturing and agriculture. And due to automation, due to artificial intelligence, we are witnessing job losses. For example, driverless cars. Due to automation, there will be some job loss. But we are witnessing an increase in growth in e-commerce segment. We see delivery boys working for Flipkart, Amazon. So there we are witnessing a growth in jobs. But largely, I believe that there is a lot to be done in terms of job-led growth.
Yeah. So what are the challenges and how do we overcome those, particularly in the wake of artificial intelligence and automation?
Sir, currently 50% of our population is working in agriculture sector. So I believe that we need to create jobs in non-farm sector. And we also need to focus on labor-intensive industries like textile, leather, apparel. So we need to promote jobs in those sectors. And we also need to provide credit to entrepreneurs, because startups are engines of job-led growth, we can say. And we also need to promote MSME sector, because they are calm in use of job creation, as they say it.
Thank you. That's all, Chairman.
What is judicial review?
So judicial review is a mechanism through which judiciary can check the arbitrariness of any legislation or executive actions.
What gives this power to the judiciary?
There are articles in the Constitution, like Article 32, and Article 226 that gives judiciary the prerogative to issue writs by which it can check the arbitrariness of legislature and executive.
You have been dealing with rights of women.
Yes.
Can you tell us some of the laws which have been enacted to prevent crime against women?
So first is Domestic Violence Act 2005, then Dowry Prohibition Act of 1961. And then recently after the Nirbhaya gas raid, there was an amendment in the criminal justice system as well. And we have PCP and DD Act that prevents female infanticide. So these are some of the legislations. And Vishakha guidelines was there by the Supreme Court. Thereafter, a law was enacted to prevent sexual harassment at workplace.
IPC,
yes, sir, in the
IPC. In IPC, can you recall some of the issues? And you said infanticide?
Yes, sir.
Speedicide or PLGT?
Both of them, if I remember correctly, sir.
Okay. And IPC, do you remember something?
Sir, there are some provisions, but I don't recall the exact section.
Since you have been associated with ensuring safety and empowerment, can you suggest some reform in law?
Sir, we need to criminalize marital rape. It was recommended by J.S. Verma committee. Then there are some other provisions like adultery, which needs to be gender neutral. Currently it is biased. So these are some of the legal changes that need to be done.
What is the, you said it is gender neutral. What is the bias against women in this
adultery? If a male member is in relationship with another after getting married, it is a crime under the legal provisions, but sin does not apply to women. So I think there is a bias there.
If a male is in a relationship with another unmarried female, it is no offense if it is with consent.
No, sir, after marriage I am talking.
Yes, even if a married man lives with a woman with consent and both are adult, what is the offense?
But the consent might not be there.
If there is consent, what is
in that case, there is no offense. But if it is without consent.
If it is in the case of a married woman, it is an offense and that is adult. Okay, that this is the bias. Now, can you tell us something about prohibition law in Bihar? Is it a success? What is the view on
it? Sir, prohibition against liquor has many positive health and social consequences, because those money that were spent for liquor is now being used for education and health. Then I think in terms of law enforcement, since Bihar has a porous border, especially with Nepal, so there is difficulty in law enforcement, and it has impacted the revenue of Bihar to some extent. It has impacted tourism also. But in long term, I believe this is a good step, provided it is enforced properly.
Okay, last question. Some salient features of right to education.
Right to Education Act, there is a policy of no detention where children.
Yes.
Okay. Then, sir, there has to be a school per 1 kilometer or some distance.
Yes.
There.
How do you ensure this?
By setting up new schools under the Sarv Shiksha Abhiyan, so many schools are being set up. So.
Don't we involve private sector in this RT?
Yes, sir. There is a provision that 25% seats has to be reserved.
For the first time,
yes,
reservation has been like private sector has been. Okay, thank you.
Mr. Kumar, how serious is the NPA problem in the public sector banks?
Nearly 10% of the assets in public sector banks are non-performing. So I think it is pulling India's private investment, and it is retarding growth.
Okay. Now recently, Reserve Bank of India, they have redefined the NPA. Are you aware of that?
Yes, sir.
And what is the implication of that? How serious will be the implication on the public sector banks?
Sir, earlier there was a tendency to delay recognition, but now the RBI has told that you have to recognize, the commercial banks has to recognize as early as possible, so that prompt corrective action or any other reform measures will kick in. And also the for MSME in the budget, we saw that since earlier there was 90 days threshold, but now it has been extended to 180 days. So these two are the current developments.
Any steps which government has taken to address this problem?
The economic survey had talked about 4 R's, the recognition, recapitalization of public sector banks, then resolution and reform. The government is working on an Indradhanush plan that aims at
recapitalization. Been announced?
Sorry, sir?
What is the extent of, or what is the quantum of refinancing?
It was at 2.11 lakh crores. And in the first phase, 80,000 crores have been allocated for recapitalization.
Last financial year.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What do you understand? What do you mean by human development index?
So human
development parameters.
Human development index was conceptualized by Amartya Sen and Mahbub Ul Haq, and it is a part of UNDP report. There are three parameters. The first is access to education. Then per capita income is there, and one more indicator related to health is there.
And as far as Bihar is concerned, where does it figure?
Sir, it is below the national average, that is for sure, but I am not aware of the exact ranking, sir.
Recently, NITI Aayog has also come out with another index on pertaining to health.
Yes.
Are you aware of that? Last week, in fact, it was given it.
Yes, sir.
And as per this index, where is Bihar placed?
Again, sir, below the national average, that is for sure, but I am not aware of the exact index.
You are not aware of that?
Yes.
Okay. Last question. What is democratic decentralization?
Democratic decentralization means taking democracy to the last year of governance, especially the third year. That means empowering the grassroots level governance, that is the panchayats and municipalities or the urban local bodies.
How does it function in Bihar?
In Bihar it has been, I think, good because 50% reservation to women has also been given. That is a revolutionary step that is not seen in any other state. And elections are held regularly, and I believe that funds are also allocated. But there are some reforms like panchayatpati syndrome is there, where the male counterparts rule on the behalf of women, so that needs to be taken care of.
Thank you.
All right. Sir, this is your first attempt?
This is my third attempt, but first interview, sir.
First interview. You talked in the UPSC CAPF assistant commandant. What is that?
Sir, it is a group A gadget officer for Central Armed Police Forces.
You didn't join it.
So the joining is about to commence in April.
I see. So basically, when you will leave the current job that you are there, then you will join there in April pending the...
Yes, sir. I have already left the Samson's job.
I see. Okay. Now, let me ask you one thing. Today in the news, there is this, the meeting of the FATF in Paris is taking a discussing about financing to Pakistan. Have you read the news? Have you heard the news?
Sir, I read last day's newspaper, so based on that I can answer, sir.
What is this all about, FATF?
Sir, FATF stands for Financial Action Task Force. It is an intergovernmental body that takes care of money laundering and terror financing. So India is a member of that organization.
No, but in the context of Pakistan, you need to explain now.
Yes, sir. India is trying to isolate Pakistan diplomatically. With other nations that have been victims of terrorism in the past. So I think that is a platform that India can leverage to put pressure on Pakistan to curb terror havens.
Which are the countries in the FATF who are supporting stopping the financing to Pakistan?
So India and US are definitely there, but I'm not sure of the other countries.
Okay. There is a very important visit taking place to India from today onwards.
To India.
But to India, yes. Can you remember what it is?
No, sir.
Iran president?
Yes, sir.
Do you know his name?
Yes, sir. Hassan Rouhani.
Hassan Rouhani. Can you explain to me the importance of the visit to India?
Sir, India has not many laborers working in West Asia. Then for energy security also, relations with Iran is important. And in terms of fighting Islamic fundamentalism, relations with Iran is also important. So these are three are the main things that I believe, sir.
You missed out on the most important thing.
Which one, sir?
Chabahar.
Chabahar, yes, sir. It is important because we can access Central Asia through Chabahar road.
Okay. Now I'll ask. Prime Minister had gone to UAE.
Yes, sir.
Palestine, UAE and Oman. Five agreements were signed with UAE and seven with Oman. Out of this, name only one important agreement, solid agreement, which is in, good for India, which you consider to be something concrete. One with UAE, one with Oman. If you've read it only, then you can identify the importance of those agreements.
So in case of Oman, we have an agreement where we are going to co-develop port of Dukm, that is located strategically important to Chabahar port, that is located very close.
What will be the importance for us?
We can check Chinese influence in the Indian Ocean region.
No, but we are going to develop the port. But what benefit we get out of it, that is what is important.
So we will get access to the Central Asia region. It will help us.
Central Asia?
Yeah, it will be a gateway towards that. Just like Chabahar port is there.
Okay. You identified the correct thing, but you are not able to identify why it is important. Anyway, for UAE?
Sir, for UAE, we have signed a pact for counter-terrorism. We will be jointly fighting terror.
Okay. What is the GDP growth rate of Bihar?
Sir, it is more than 10%, almost 10.2% GDP growth.
In Human Development Index, on an all-India basis, where does it stand?
Sir, it is below the national average. I'm not
what is the
exact
national average?
So it is 0.524 out of 1.
0.624, you're wrong.
Sorry.
Which country has 0.99? No one has 1. Which country in the world has 0.99?
Sir, some Scandinavian country is there, probably Norway.
Norway, yes. Correct. Now, NITI Aayog brought out a health index for all states. Who is number one and who is number last? Who is the last?
Kerala is number one. And last, sir, I am not recall.
Uttar Pradesh. Where is Bihar?
Somewhere from the bottom, but below the national average.
Far below the national. Another index came out about percentage of anemic women in India. What is the percentage of anemic women in India?
Sir, I'm not sure about the number.
In Bihar?
Not sure, sir.
You are not reading this? Okay. Liquor ban. Is it a beneficial measure or a harmful measure?
Sir, it is a beneficial measure in total.
Why?
Because it has positive
health. But the state is losing money?
Yes, sir. But the state was losing money also for fighting crimes, the petty crimes that has come down after liquor ban. So anyway, it is going to get compensated. It has also positive health consequences. The state used to spend a lot of money for alcohol problems.
Okay. Why first preference for IPS?
Sir, I believe the primary role of the state is to ensure safety and security of citizens. Welfare and development comes next to it. And I am also attracted towards uniformed services. There is a sense of honor and dignity attached to Indian police service. That is why I am
Would you agree to a statement that police is an indispensable pillar for strengthening democracy in this country?
Yes, sir.
Would you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
Why do you agree with this? Give some constitutional provisions to support your constitutional or legal. Don't make a general statement.
The first is, sir, rule of law is a basic structure of the Indian constitution. In order to safeguard rule of law, police is an important pillar.
Rule of law is, has always been there.
Yes, sir.
Where is it written rule of law is a pillar? In which is it written in the preamble?
It is not written in the preamble, it is an implied provision, sir.
Again, you use constitution specific provision to say that it is a pillar for strengthening democracy. Use only the constitutional provisions.
Sir, there is Article 355 that says that the center is a that the center has a responsibility to ensure law and order and the security provisions of the state.
You are not getting the question. Empowerment of women. You have done some work in your hobbies.
Yes, sir.
What are the constitutional safeguards for empowerment of women?
The first is the Article 15 that
says. Article 15. Only give the articles, no, don't have to explain. 15 is there. What else?
Article 14, right to equality.
No.
15 is all right.
Article 39 is there, sir.
What does it say?
It says that there
that
should
is
be
DP.
DP.
That is DP. You talk of the enforceable things.
In terms of fundamental rights. This is the exact.
This is all. Only 15 you can add it.
Article 24 is there, sir, that talks about prohibition of trafficking against women.
24, 23, is
23
it?
Article, sir. Article
23. Yes, what else?
So this is all in terms of...
This is all you know?
Yes.
What about 73, 74 amendment?
What sir, wait, I was confining my discussion to some fundamental rights.
Well.
Yeah, that is also there, sir.
What does it give to the women?
So it talks about political empowerment of women.
No, what does it say specifically? You tell me that.
Yes, sir. It provides for reservation of women in...
Exactly. In these elective bodies.
Yes, sir.
Computer science is your subject.
Yes, sir.
Hmm? What is Digital India program?
So the government aims at digitalizing the services so that the benefits goes to the last mile.
Would you say that the main thrust of this program is to extend internet facility to the villages? Is that a correct statement?
Yes, sir, it is.
How do you say that?
The BharatNet project is there that aims at.
Very good.
Yes,
so under this project, what work is being done?
Sir, 2.5 lakh gram panchayats.
It is being connected?
Yes, sir.
With the internet?
Optical fiber.
Optical fiber. How much has been done so far?
In the first phase, it has reached the target around 1 lakh.
Yes, sir. When was the second phase started?
Sir, last year itself, 2017 itself. It was
good. No.
Yes, sir.
You do jogging, blogging, teaching.
Yes, sir.
What is the meaning of all this? Why do you do all this?
Sir, blog is an online platform that helps me to refine my writing skills as well as to connect with like-minded people or to support any political or environmental cause.
Teaching.
Sir, teaching gives me satisfaction when I, whatever limited knowledge I have, when I teach it to someone else, gives me satisfaction, sir. Sir, since I am motivated towards uniform services, I believe that being healthy is one of the primary requirements.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, will you be able to keep up these hobbies when you join the service?
Sir, jogging definitely, and teaching also I'll try, sir.
Alright, we close the interview.